Jason Samuels Smith. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
See, it's an honor having him talking to us here. He's a great, 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 one of the best, if not the best, tap dance performers. Okay? Jason, tell us a little bit about your career as a tap dance performer. And tell us, what in the tap dance amazes you most?
Well, I've done a lot of things in my career, some television, some film. I was on Broadway once. I teach all over the world. I participate in many different festivals, tap festivals, music festivals, folk art festivals. I collaborate with people in the tap community and also outside of the tap community. People in the flamenco community.
Really?
I've collaborated with an artist from India, and he does Kathak, and I do tap dance. I've collaborated with vocalists, with rappers, with musicians, with visual artists. I mean, all kinds of people. I've designed a tap shoe now that people are wearing in many, many places.
Really?
I started a tap festival in Los Angeles about 16 years ago. And, you know, I'm just continuing to promote the art form. The reason I think I love it so much is because of the people. You know, the people, the elders in the community that have dedicated their lives to this art form, and they were willing to share everything that they had with us, with the next generation. So I felt so honored to be one of these students that I felt it's my responsibility to share what I learned as well. So it's just about the community, the people, the special people that are very talented and intelligent and, you know, brilliant dancers and musicians, but really humble people, really, you know, genuinely nice people who want to share what they have and they want to see people succeed. So I like this attitude. I like to be able to help other people, even if it's just with art form or confidence or music, dance, balance, something.
Right.
You know, I feel like I've accomplished something if I help somebody.
And you say you travel. How do people, for example, contact you if they are like, oh my God, I need to meet this guy, I need some help, I need his help, I want, you know, have some, you know, classes or whatever.
Social media.
Social media.
I'm on every avenue of social media.
Okay.
Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat.
I'm following you.
Yeah, so I realize this is the best way to communicate.
Right.
And a lot of people offer me work on these mediums now because I don't know them personally, but maybe they've heard about me or they've seen some video and they contact me. They send me a random message and say, hey, I'd love to have you come teach or perform.
Right.
So then I connect with them. I have a manager. I connect them with my manager.
Right.
They organize everything and
find out your agenda.
Yeah, it's not so difficult. It's just, for me, it's about time.
Right.
You know, if you want to invite me next month, it's probably not possible.
No, next year maybe.
Next year is more possible. So, you know, time is,
right,
is the only thing. But I'm, you know, I love to travel and I love to experience a new community. That
different cultures.
Different culture, because I love to learn about new culture, language, food, you know, drinks, you know, everything. And then the local dance, because the dance is the history of the people.
It's different. Even though it's the same dance, right? It's like tap dance in Brazil is something, tap dance in US is something else. Because of the culture, because of the people,
but it makes
the behavior.
Exactly.
Right?
But it makes it so interesting. Because
right,
then the culture, the tap culture here is different because it has Brazilian culture.
Right.
And Brazilian history and Brazilian music. And so it makes it so interesting. Even to us Americans, we're inspired by the dancers here. Because there's a different feeling, there's a different approach, and a different story to be told. So, you know, the dance, I think, is a very important element in every culture. And if you can absorb something from the dance of the people, then you can learn about the people more.
Exactly.
You know? So I love dance and tap, especially because it's music and dance.
Mm-hmm.
It's not just one or the other. It's everything at the same time.
Right.
It's very physical. It's very mental. It's very spiritual. It covers every subject that you would learn in school.
Right.
Math, science, language, history, physical education. I mean, you name it, tap dance is all of those things. And it's the history of the people. Even if it's, you know, originally from America, mm-hmm. the people that are doing it now are, they're putting their own culture and history into the art form. So it's just gonna keep expanding and growing with all the people that are adding to it. But my main concern as a teacher is that people maintain the connection to the root of the dance. And this style as we know it began in the United States. So it's important for people to know all of the people who contributed to this right. leading up to now. It's not so old that you can't research the history.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, sure. I guess technically tap dance started in the late 1800s, mm-hmm. but it really started before then.
Right.
That's just when the first tap dancer was recognized mm-hmm. as being a tap dancer. But tap dance comes from African dance, you know, and so African dance is maybe the oldest dance in the world,
yes.
you know, and so we still carry those stories and that history within our movements, mm-hmm. and we might not even know the origin of all of these steps and rhythms,
right.
but it's inside of us, and putting it out there, actually expressing these ideas and thoughts is helping us to connect with our own past and our right. own history, especially in the United States. I mean, most of African Americans, we don't have so much knowledge about our past because our records were destroyed. They made sure our names were changed, our countries were not, we don't know which countries we come from, the languages, our religion, everything was taken away. But our dance, our music, our food,
it's alive.
It's alive inside of us. And tap dance is one way to project that.
Right. It's amazing. Yeah,
it is. It's a very special art form. I love it.
So what you're saying is also like tap dancing is not only tap dancing, something much bigger, like, right?
I believe it.
The energy and everything. Right?
Exactly.
Okay.
It's a way for people to continue a certain type of history,
mm-hmm.
because I believe music and dance are some of the oldest things on the planet that people have been doing. If you speak, you make sounds,
right.
your heart beats inside you, this is a rhythm that's always happening.
Exactly.
This is the first rhythm.
Yeah.
And the first rhythm you hear is your mother's heartbeat when you're inside the womb.
Mm-hmm.
So this is the human connection. You know, it's deeper than just putting a pair of shoes on uh-huh. and, you know, getting a cane and a top hat.
Right.
Tap dance. Yeah, no. There's a legacy.
Uh-huh.
And I feel very strongly to stay close to this legacy because it's a beautiful history. And it's also very ugly. You know, it's like human history, you know. There's a lot of tragedy, but there's also triumph.
Right.
So, I love it.
Okay, good. What do you think... let me ask you now, Brazil, what is your favorite music of Brazil? What is your favorite food? Just curious, well, today, how many times have you been to Brazil? Come on, tell us.
At least 15 or 16 times.
Wow, okay, so he knows a lot. Especially so
I like so many styles here. I mean, I love pagode, I love samba, I love bossa nova, forró, I mean, everything.
Forró, you know how to dance forró.
A little bit, you know. So I appreciate all the styles of music here, and I'm still learning about all of the styles.
Right.
I think this is such a beautiful country because it's rich with so much culture, you know, incredible people, and the energy here is very special. It's not like anywhere else I've been, so. The tap dancers here are so passionate about learning and dancing because their passion is already in this culture.
Uh-huh.
The people here, you guys love life. And
right.
so it comes out every day in how you speak and how you talk to each other, how you dance, how you eat food, everything is
passion.
Yeah. So I appreciate this. And both of my parents have been coming here also for years before I was born.
Oh, really?
And so they've been telling me so many stories. I mean, I grew up hearing about Carnival and, you know, going to Ipanema and Copacabana and Rio de Janeiro. And I have a sister who lives in Saquarema.
Oh, really?
So I go visit her. Yes. So there's many connections of my family to Brazil, to the culture.
So it's like a second home for you.
It's like a second home. Yeah. I love it here. So all the styles, and I still have not been to Carnival.
Oh, no kidding. 15 times coming to Brazil, he hasn't been to Carnival. No, what is going to be your first time in Carnival?
Yeah, hopefully this year coming up. And
2016.
I hope so.
But come to São Paulo too. I know the best Carnival parade is in Rio.
I would love to come to São Paulo.
But São Paulo is also pretty.
It's amazing too.
Yes, it's pretty. Rio has more time in the parade.
It's different.
So it's a little bit more, how can I say?
Commercial?
Yes. Tourists. It's more like for tourists.
More popular.
Yes, more popular. Mm-hmm. But São Paulo is beautiful too. Come to São Paulo in São Paulo.
I would love to come to.
Okay, well, one day.
Yes,
okay.
I hope. Please.
That's
my dream. It's my dream.
Okay, good. Jason, so tell us a little bit about your participation on the 16th gala that is going to be tonight at MASP and four more days. How's your participation on that?
Well, you know, I get to dance with some great musicians from the area. And share the stage with not just the professional tap dancers here, but also the local amateur tap dancers. Right. And just to share some of this art with the community here, I think it's very special because people are just discovering tap dance here. Even yesterday when we were jamming outside on Avenida Paulista, we were there and people just kept stopping and watching and listening and they were so fascinated because this sound is magnetic. It just draws you in. You hear the rhythm, you hear the feet. So hopefully tonight with the performance, we can maybe inspire some more people and introduce the art form to them so they can see many different levels. Because every tap dancer has their own individual style and voice. And you get to see that in a performance with solo performances. When you're with a group, you know, it's a different energy, but when you're seeing soloists, you can hear the person's individual voice. So hopefully I can express myself tonight, share some of my joy and my love with the people, and hopefully inspire and educate some people along the way.
Yes, because this is a positive thing that everybody can do it, right?
Exactly.
Young people, older.
Young, old.
Right.
You can be older and start when you're in your 60s or 70s. You can begin, you know.
Uh-huh.
You don't even need to have two legs. There are famous tap dancers with one leg.
Really?
There's a famous tap dancer right now. He's a younger tap dancer in New Jersey. And he had cancer, so he had to have his leg amputated.
And he's a tap dancer.
He's a tap dancer. He's
life goes on and is
still
enjoying.
Continuing. So there are no limitations.
Okay.
And you can come as you are. You don't have to have any training in dance or music. You know, if you have rhythm, if you have a heartbeat
and passion, right.
You like to dance, you like to move, and you love music, tap dance is perfect.
That's great.
Yeah.
That's amazing. Thank you very much. Nice to meet you. It's
really
amazing
nice
having you here. And we're going
to
be watching you tonight.
Obrigado.
Obrigado.
Tchau. Até mais.